Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lukas, and today I want to talk about the pgset IO view and the everyday DBA perspective on why it matters. The pgset IO view is a new feature in the upcoming Postgres 16 release that was committed about 3 weeks ago. This was committed by Andres Freund, who was an author primarily Plagueman. On this blog post by Depesz on his blog, he talks about how to make use of this new view. And in fact, he references a post that I wrote a couple of weeks ago where I described some of the experience of reviewing this patch in previous iterations. I do want to take a look at this post though, because I think what Depesz describes here is how he would use this as a DBA when this is released in Postgres 16. Pgset.io tracks all the IO activity in a Postgres system. And really what's new here is that this represents an all-up view that's very complete. Previously, you would have ways to get information about individual queries or individual tables, but there wasn't really a way to say, here's everything that happened and how much of that was spent in auto vacuum versus individual queries or background workers and such. Now, this looks like a lot of data, but what's nice about this is that it is actually fairly compact. In a sense, you will always get 30 rows if your system is really busy or if your system is not busy. What really matters is which counter values are going with how. As the page describes here, these stats here are global. So you can see the stats for the whole database server. He runs a Pgbench to have a test case for the set of data. This is a Pgbench with scale factor 1000. It's a fairly reasonably sized database. Afterwards, pgset.io looks very different. They can sort this view by the number of reads. For example, we can say, give me the subsystem of Postgres that caused the most reads in this time frame since the last reset. And so we can say that here, the auto vacuum worker spent the most time reading information next to background workers, which are like parallel workers, and then regular client backend. So these are the individual connections to the database. Now we can do the same for writes, of course. Here you can see the writes were actually mostly issued by a client backend. As the page notes here, this doesn't actually tell us which tables or which individual backends are to blame, but it does help you pinpoint which subsystem of Postgres to look at, where you can then have other information like from the pgstat user tables to really dig into these specific statistics. There are a couple of other statistics here. Extends are something that's a bit special in Postgres, and they were previously not really visible. This happens when you're inserting data into a table, and the table needs to grow to accommodate the amount of data you're inserting. Now, in this case, there are actually a lot of extends because this was essentially an empty table before. And this can be helpful to know and was hard to track in previous versions of Postgres. You can combine reads, writes, and extends to understand how many bytes of I/O you're doing. Each of those is essentially a counter value of 8 kilobyte pages. And so you can multiply it out to get how much was read. For example, when we have 7,000 reads, that means it's roughly 55 megabytes of data that was read. It's important to note that this is data as read from the database's perspective. Your Linux operating system cache may actually cache things, and Postgres doesn't know about that. There is a current patch in the current Postgres commit fest, which may make it into 16, we don't know yet, which will also track timing. I think to really get a good measurement whether these operations were cached in the operating system page cache or not, we'll need to also have timing information at this level. Sometimes you got to be a bit careful to really make a final assessment just based on this data. Now, there's two other things that are interesting. Evictions are something that you didn't really have good visibility on before. And this is when something has to be written to disk because shared buffers, which is a fixed size array essentially of sorts, doesn't have enough space for a new data that should be read in. And so Postgres evicts another buffer to then be able to load some other data. Reuses are a bit of a special case, and this is mostly related to the special ring buffers that you can now see here with bulk reads and bulk writes. You can also just reset this view. The pgset reset shared function can be used to just reset the I/O statistics. For example, here you can see just the statistics for a single pgbench run. That's the patch notes. I wish I had it on my production server. I wish too. And if you're interested in reading more about pgset.io, I wrote about pgset.io in a blog post a couple of weeks ago, where you can also see more details about the bulk read and bulk write strategies and some other edge cases that are now more clearly visible with pgset.io. I'm really excited for Postgres 16. Got to wait another probably half a year for it to be available, but then we can finally have better IO statistics in Postgres. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.